Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to be talking about graphic design, file structure, and folder structure, and organization. Once you get a job in an agency or as an in-house designer, a lot of people besides you might need to access your files at some point. So you need to keep your files named perfectly and have them organized in a way that makes sense to everybody so they can find them easily or find them through a search easily. And this also helps you come off as someone who cares and who is detail-oriented, which is a big deal. If you're a freelancer, you might not actually be sharing your files with other people, but it's a really good way to help you find your files easily, too. Now, as you'll notice as we're getting into this, I'm a huge fan of long folder names and long file names because you can put a lot of keywords in there that'll help people find your file. It just really helps with search. Now, first up, I have a freelance folder. You could also call this projects or whatever you want to call it, that holds all of the clients and the projects that you have. Inside that, we have a folders folder, and we also have two client folders. Now, the way these are named are an acronym SDT that stands for Senior Division Tactics. And I always have my own acronym, even if the company doesn't go by an acronym. Now, if we click this, we have two projects inside. Let me make this a little bit bigger. We've got SDT, which is the acronym that I came up with. Then we have the project name and then the project type. So our project name is Streamlining Christmas and the type of project is a proposal. And here we have the benefits of aging, which is the name of the white paper and white paper. All right, so if I click on this one, I've got six different folders inside that all have different purposes. I've got a content folder, and this is something that you'll probably get from the writers or the content creators. This will probably be a Word document or just anything that has to do with content. All that goes in here. Your document fonts are all the fonts you use in your InDesign file or your Illustrator file. And I usually don't have anything in this folder until the very end of the project when I package these files. InDesign actually makes a folder with document fonts and links, and I take those out and stick them in the document fonts folder. Edits are for any edits that come back from an internal customer like your boss or maybe an account executive or external clients. This might have emails in it. It might have photos that you've taken of a printed page with red marks on it. I just keep all the edits right in here. And then info for project is everything you get at the beginning of a project. This would be your creative brief, any photos of notes that you might have taken during meetings about this particular project, and just anything that doesn't fit anywhere else in any of these folders. Links are actually the photos or PDFs that you used in your project itself. A lot of times this might be empty too until the very end when you package your document. And then logos, this is something that I just use personally because I hated to go and search for the logo over and over again, the white version, the full color version. So I always just copy and paste them in here and then I have them throughout the whole project. But I do delete them because they're usually stored on a server somewhere. So you don't really need a whole bunch of copies of the logos themselves. And then these are the actual projects. So these are the InDesign files or Photoshop files. I don't put them in a folder, but if you wanted to, you could create a projects folder and put them in there. Now let's go to this second project, the Benefits of Aging White Paper. And as you can see, it has all of the same folders inside it and then the project itself. Now, sometimes you might find that you don't have any edits at all for this project. So you might think, well, I want to delete that folder. I don't need it. So I'm going to delete it. But personally, I don't think that's a good idea because let's say a month out, your client comes back with a change. And so you're like, oh, well, I deleted that folder. I'll just make a new one. So you make a new folder, but you're like, oh, what did I call that? I don't quite remember. So I'll call this changes. Well, now this has been put at the very top, and if someone is looking through your files, trying to find the edits, they're going to notice that it's not where it normally goes, and they might have a little trouble finding it if it's up here. So I really recommend keeping the folder structure the same, even if there are empty folders. It doesn't take a lot of space on your hard drive to have empty folders, so I think it definitely makes sense to keep them in there for that reason. All right, so let's go to the second client. we have an infographic here, and we have all those same folders with the projects themselves as Illustrator files here. This is also the place where you'll want to keep PDFs of your projects. I never add final to these because, you know, a lot of times you'll have changes after that. But if you're going to send one of the PDFs to a client, go ahead and take off the version. You can just have it say TBW Tennis Elbow Infographic, and that'll be fine to send to a client. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is this folders folder up here. So if we click on this, this just has all of the folders that you need for each of your projects. So whenever I start a new project, I can just copy this. They're empty folders. I can go ahead and create a new project. We'll call this one so-and-so white paper. And then I'll paste all of those folders in here. Now, I don't drag them from the folders because then they won't be in here anymore. So it's always just a good idea to copy and paste those. All right, I hope this folder structure video has helped you come up with a new system for your files. I worked at different companies over the last 18 years, and a couple of them used very similar systems to this, and that's where I sort of stole it from. This has worked really well for me in my freelance business and at new positions that I've taken. All right, and that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.